Hello. So wanted to also cover mega mode one more time with the import Rails command that ships with mega mode. Except also cover an option with it called submodule. And I'll show you where the documentation for this is. And then we'll go over that in this video. So let's go to the CLI reference here. It is down here. And we go to import Rails. So the import Rails command comes with a submodule option. And what this does is instead of just copying that folder in, and adding like a regular folder to your Git repository, it's going to add it as a submodule. And the use case for this is actually, let's say if you're actually importing a project from the Jets and you're running for an extended period of time, and you want to keep the history separate for a while. This is actually a decent use case for submodules, actually. When you have two separate repositories and kind of want to combine them a little bit and one manage the other. And the import project is going to have no idea that it's being actually managed from the parent project, only the parent project in this submodule setup is going to know anything about the child project, and that parent project is the thing that keeps everything in sync. Okay, so we'll kind of grab almost this command and we'll kind of get going here. So I have the same demo project, except I removed basically the rack application from it. So I'm kind of starting, it's basically just like the initial starter CRUD project with no mega mode in there yet, no rack application in there yet. And and now I'm gonna also push this to the submodule demo branch here, so it's gonna be available and everything. And then I'm gonna grab since I have actually commit access to this, I'm gonna grab the Git URL there, and then now that option submodule. So that should do it. So let's run the command, and it's doing the exact same thing like it did before, except this time it's importing as a submodule. Check out, it's right here. It says, "Oh, Git submodule add," and it's basically adding a submodule instead of just doing a clone. That's kind of the difference there. And you can actually see, let's see, status. Okay, so you're gonna see the status. And I'm gonna actually just add the files to the Git staging error so then we can see kind of summarize for more altogether the status. And we'll see what files were changed. So it added this .git_modules file. So what is that all about? Git modules. So that's just a file that Git adds to manage submodules, and this kind of is printing out a little bit funny here, but basically it's showing submodule rack and then path rack, so it keeps track of rack up there, and then also the rack folder, and it points to the URL. Let's see if we can cat it out one more time, is a little bit better. There it goes. Okay, and then the routes file. So that was kind of changed too. So let's say you do git catch, and then we can see the difference here. So the difference is, it removed the current cache all route, and then what mega mode or import Rails command did was it added the mega mode route. And so that's nothing different from the previous video that I did, but I'm just kind of showing it to you here again. And then it added like a new file. It's not really a file, it's a folder, but that's how the submodule or Git with submodules, that's how it identifies it. It's kind of printing out a little funny here because right now I'm uploading video and so running the internet connection is a little slow. So excuse that. And then it also adds this submodule cheat sheet dot MD. So what's that all about? Actually, when you run the import Rails command, it will generate this cheat sheet specific to your project. So this is actually the project that I'm working with right now, Jets Mega Demo. This is the Jets project that I'm importing the Rails application to, right? So let me kind of just show it to you here. So here's the Jets Mega Demo right here. And then what we're gonna do is we've already imported the rack app as a submodule. And here's what's important about the cheat sheet. The cheat sheet gives you a summary of the commands you need to know. So if you don't have a lot of time, then just this is all you need to know right here. Cheat sheet summary. On a fresh clone, you need to do a git submodule init. That's very important. That pretty much sets up the git submodules. Then you just have to run this command git submodule update. And then thereafter, whenever you do like a git pull and git status, and you see and it might say that the rack folder has changed, then you just have to run this command again and git submodule update. See, this is what normal. See, updating, this is what people normally would do, just git submodule update. And that's kind of it, that is it to git submodules. So I think the reason why git submodules, people have sometimes have difficulties with it, including myself, is because as long as you stay with this flow, everything's be okay, all right? But if you start going, okay, well, what's, I want to change this file myself, the git modules file myself, or you want to go into the dot git folder, the hidden folder, and change things in there. Then you're gonna get out of sync because git modules command, the submodule command is no longer being able to manage all those kind of internal files for you. Now, It's you can still get yourself out of those jams if you mess around with those files. You just have to know kind of what files to edit, and hopefully I'll cover that in another blog post or video. But it's not so bad once you actually know what files are to edit. If you're a tinkerer and kind of mess with those files, but you don't mess with those files, then this is all you kind of really need to know. Where is it? Where's this cheat sheet? You just need to know get a submodule update. And then that's kind of all you kind of need to know. There's also a more kind of thorough explanation in depth about how submodules kind of work here for the people who are curious, and goes into like even more thorough detail about how submodules kind of work here. So that's it. And remember, this was generated and it's very specific to actually the project that you're working with. It happens to spit out this URL here because that's the project I'm working with, but whatever project you're working with, that import command kind of figures that out, infers it, and then generates this cheat sheet for you. And then, okay. So let's see what else I kind of want to do here. I wanted to also just deploy this so you can see it actually working. It just works off the bat. So let's go ahead and kick off a deploy and then kind of wait. And actually, I have to copy actually the environmental file again. So let me do that. This is also covered in the other video. So let me just copy that in and then I'll kick off a deploy. And then since this deploy is going to take a little time, I'm going to go ahead and pause the video so you guys don't have to wait. And I'll come right back. So that completed deploying. So let me just show you again that the thing is the application. The application is still working with MegaMode, even though we use the Git module flag. So that is the home splash page. Here's the post controller scaffold. This is just hitting only the Jets app, and Books is hitting the Rails app via MegaMode. Info also hits the Rails app via MegaMode. And so just want to show you that. Okay. I think that is it. So hopefully you found that helpful. Again, the use case for submodules is when you have maybe a project where you want to keep the history separate for an extended period of time, and you just kind of want those two things to be separate, and this is actually a decent use case for it. Submodules are definitely a little bit tricky. It takes a little bit of time to get used to. So this is why one of the reasons I generated this cheat sheet. Hopefully that's helpful. I found it helpful. I still refer to it because I just don't use it enough. But when I need to use it, I just kind of reference command and just run it. And eventually kind of get used to it. Okay. All right. Hopefully you guys found this video helpful. If you like videos like this, be sure to give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends to encourage more content like this. And if you like videos like this, subscribe to this channel to watch future videos. Thanks so much for watching. Cheers.